push and wait till you see the teapot. Colored pens. Mm-hmm. Yeah, a lot of colors here. There are three verdant little succulent. And put it over your chair. It's very cozy. Hi again. It's nice to meet with you virtually. Yeah, it's been a few days since our last chat. I've set the camera up this time above so that you can oversee what I'm doing here today for you. Does that work? Perfect. Thank you so much for lending the keys. I did. I picked them up and I let myself in. So you're away for one more night, is that right? Okay. So I went through your entire questionnaire. Thank you so much. I took all of your answers and went shopping and selected all the items that I thought would match with your interests. Mm-hmm. Many of my clients are looking for an evening desk set up where they can sit down for half an hour or an hour with a tea or a decaffeinated coffee and just relax with some writing or a book. So I'm ready to get started here. Great. I'm going to start by preparing the surface of this beautiful desk. Yeah, you said this has been in the family for some time. Nice. Your great-grandmother. Okay, well, I'm going to prepare the surface, starting with a little brushing to just make sure that we get all the dust out of Oh, you see the lamp there? Yes, I did find the size that you were looking for. Yes, it's perfect, isn't it? Yeah, it's hard to find the small size of the salt lamp. And they had the white ones too, but you said you wanted this color. It really does have a beautiful soft glow. Okay, I'm going to go in this direction now. Don't worry if you fall asleep during this call. I am recording it, so if there's anything else you'd like to add or take away, just let me know. Okay, so now I'm going to polish the desk with essential oil. I'm going to use my special polisher. It's a beautiful spring blend, and It's got a very light, delicate scent. And a lot of my clients say that it makes them feel extremely relaxed. So I'm going to add a little bit of this. Just going to polish this whole area. It's very good for the wood. It's a special blend that is safe and actually very good for the wood. For skin too. I don't mind getting it on my hands. It smells so good in here. When you get home tomorrow and you walk into your writing room, you'll be amazed at the fresh, delicate scent. So now we'll get into a few of the elements of your desk setup. I have a couple of coasters here. Yeah, you said that you like to drink tea at night. Sure to get something soft enough for this gorgeous wood. Some coasters can be quite rough on wood, but this is made of cork, so it's perfect. I have two, so that if you have a glass of water or something else with your tea, you've got two. So put this right here, and you said that although you like to drink tea at night, you like to make just a little bit. You like to fill up your kettle and your teapot and steep your tea and fill up a small cup a couple of times. So I found this nice little tiny cup. That's nice, isn't it? It has a beautiful design. And wait till you see the teapot. It's nice, yeah, if you just take a little tea at a time, then your tea stays nice and warm in the teapot. And then I have a larger coaster like a pot warmer. It's made of cork as well. And this is where you'll put your teapot. Yeah, isn't that cute? It has really soothing colors. It's small. It's perfect, really. It's compact for your desk. And just the perfect size for a little bit of tea. So I'll put this right here. Okay, so you said that you would just have the computer and the mouse nearby for a little typing if it something came to you that needed to go into your files. But otherwise, you'd like to work with paper and pen, pencil. Yeah, okay, so I'll move that back. Pencils. Yeah. I got you a variety of pencils. I can sharpen all of these up for you if you'd like. I'll do that a little later. But for now, I just wanted you to see what I got here. I did sharpen a few of them. Got them started. Some of them are just like an opalescent almost. Nice, clean, shiny. The one that's like this is this purple one. But I got you a couple of pencils that have little messages. This one says text less and write more. Yeah, that's great, isn't it? Especially since you're saying you want to mostly avoid the screens at this time of night. Yeah, a little bit is fine, but I get that. Mostly stick to the paper. Here's another one. It says, write well and edit often. So what kind of writing do you like to work on? Yeah, that's what I understood from your answers. You like to work in a journal, and you like to write short stories. Nice. Well, these are going to definitely help you with that. So, I'll put these pencils to one side of this because I also have some pens. You said that you wanted some colored pens. So I brought a few different kinds, so you let me know which ones interest you. I also got you a very nice pen. So these are just some fun, colorful pens, but I did pick out a very nice writing pen. I'll show you that after this. So, of these pens, which ones are catching your eye? You can have them all, but you did say, yeah, that you don't want too much clutter. I get that, yeah. So you like this one? Yeah, it has a bit of a gel effect. And you like this one? Some purples. Mm-hmm. Anything else? You like the gold? Okay. Save this for another time. Yes, I do. I offer this service 4 times a year. Spring, summer, fall, and winter. So this spring setup will be good for about 3 months. And then I can come back and set up something new for summer. Mm-hmm. So you've got 2 purple pens and 1 gold. This one is also like a gel, so it's perfect for just a little fun while you're writing. I'll add these to the pencils. I think they'll look so nice with the purple pencils. Just look at that. Oh yeah, it's very nice. Do you want me to remove the yellow ones? No, you like them? Maybe? Why don't we see what it looks like then? Take out this one. This one. Take out the rainbow one. This one looks nice with that, but maybe for summer. Mm-hmm. Isn't that beautiful? It's kind of like lilacs. Like spring blossoms. You said that you wanted some highlighters. You wanted to take a look at some highlighters. Okay, well, this is what I brought along. I'm already guessing the one you're gonna choose. Yeah, this one. Isn't it perfect with this whole theme here? Okay. There we go. While we're talking about purple. I also have this tea. It's the loose leaf tea that you said you like. Mm-hmm. I'll just place this at the back. Here is the very special pen that I selected for you. That's a very nice wood case. You mentioned that you like to incorporate a few natural items. So, this is wood, and the pen is wood as well. It is refillable. isn't it? Do you like this? They have one in a little bit of a lighter tone. Yeah, I think this is a very nice color. It looks nice on your desk. Look at that. It looks very nice. This is a winner? Good, okay. So I'm going to put this back. I'll put this over here. So now I'll take a look at the stationery. Move this to the side a little bit. You said that you would like a variety of notebooks, and you wanted one to have a bit of an agenda to it that's unrelated to your work, that has a section with notes, so that you could just write your daily goals related to your writing life and peaceful thoughts and thoughts of the day, things like that. Goals on a personal level. So what we have here is a little Moleskine ruled notebook. It's still packaged. Would you like me to open this up? Do you think you love these? Perfect. Yeah, it's compact, so it's easy to keep things clear on your desk if you want to just put it up there in the drawer here. This is great for writing down quotes or just little ideas that come to you. A nice feature. Not quite a lock, but it almost adds that little bit of protection to your personal thoughts, right? Do you want me to take this off? Of course. So there's that. You said you wanted a simple notebook as well. This is quite simple. It has a really nice texture, very smooth and cool. This one is, as you know, a hardbound notebook. So it's nice to have the two different sizes and the two different textures. It says that it has 160 pages standard ruled. It's 7.5 inches by 9.75 inches. The paper is beautiful. Nice and smooth. You have a place up here for the date. If you like to write down the date. So you like this one too. Perfect. Here's the agenda. It's pretty. It's black and it just makes you think of flowers in your nighttime garden. It's nice because, as you requested, it has quite a large section at the back for notes, and then it, like, just look at how many pages, it's a lot. And then it has each month up to December, a calendar at a glance, and then the days, just a little spot there. And I agree with you, it is so good to have a separate agenda for your personal thoughts and ideas, nothing to do with work. You like this? I thought you would. So, I could, you think this is enough with these two? I agree. I didn't want to overwhelm you, but I really do think that's, you're all set for the spring with these three. So, you also mentioned that you wanted to get back into coloring, and that sometimes before you get writing, you like to color a little bit, but that you're a little intimidated. So, I came up with a great idea. I found this cute little coloring book. It's so cute. It's the size of a postcard, because actually, they are postcards. You see? You can put a stamp there, you color, and write a little message. So, if you want to get back into coloring, and coloring helps you get in the zone before you write, I really think this is perfect. It's very pretty. Like this. I'm so happy to hear that. I can put it just a little bit out of the way though, if you'd like to refer to this book when you're in the right mood. I know that writing is your main activity at this desk, and that you sometimes like to color. If you enjoy this, I can bring you other coloring books at our next session in the summer. I have two options here, or maybe you would be interested in both. for your coloring. Let me just move these books out of the way for a minute. So, the two options are watercolor pencils or these markers, Brilliant Brush. And it says on the back that it has a soft brush tip, like painting with a marker. I thought these were neat. And this is just a beautiful set. A lot of colors here. You think you'd like the markers? Maybe something like this in the summer when you are a little more confident with your coloring. Okay. I will remember that. I will put these to the side. And I will leave these here. I'll be really interested to see what you come up with. You'll send one of the postcards to me. I would love that. Now for candles. You said that one of your absolute favorite scents is coffee. So, although I did bring this, I'm guessing you might like the other option a little better, because this is quite strong, and it is something I think you maybe would prefer to start your day with. I'll just put it here. You can decide between this and the other option. We have these honey candles. And there are three votives. It has a very light honey scent. Not invasive at all. And it just very lightly scents your space. You like this? Yeah. I do too. I have one of these on my desk. So I will get the candle holder that I brought. If you ever want a morning desk set up, I would be more than happy to help you with that. Here's a very sweet little holder and the perfect size for the honey candle. Isn't that perfect? So I can light this for you, so you can see what it looks like. You'd like to see the other things first? Okay. So, you said that you'd like a little tiny succulent or small plant, and we want to keep it nice and simple. So I have two options. This one's a little bigger, although it is a very small plant. We have this. It's in a beautiful green, small pottery. It's very pretty. Also have this cute little succulent. This one for sure, that was a quick decision. I love it when clients know what they want. So, this is the winner. Okay, let's put this here. You'd like it over here. That looks really good. You said that you also like to read before bed, and you like to read a little bit while you're writing to inspire you. Sometimes writer's block, it's true. So you said for your desk, you'd like something light in terms of length because you like to write short stories and you don't want novels, right, or nonfiction on this desk. You have that beside your bed. So I found two wonderful poetry books that I think would be perfect this season. This one. And these poems by Pablo Neruda. Look at this. You know what's nice about this one? The poems, they're all odes. And you've got English on one side and Spanish on the other. And you told me you speak a little Spanish? Perfect. So this would be fun to read before you start writing to inspire you. You like these two? Do you want just one of them on your desk, or would you like both? You'd like both. Okay, so I'm going to move the pencils for a minute. And I'm going to put the books right here. You like that placement? I like it too. And this is perfect like that. Now for the mouse. We won't keep the mouse here. I'll put it back there, but I'll just show you. I picked up a mouse and a mouse pad. Here's the mouse. It looks It looks exactly like your other one. Exactly like your other one. You broke it. Oh, I'm sorry, you lost it. I misunderstood that. So, here's the replacement mouse. And here is a mouse pad. It looks like a book, but it's a mouse pad. Mm-hmm. Cute, isn't it? Do you like this? Okay, so I will move this to the back and out of the way, but within reach, so that you can open your laptop if you need to. Okay. I have one more thing for your desk setup. Now, this is not for your desk. It's folded up. It is actually for your chair. Yeah, you just unfold it and put it over your chair. It's very cozy. In the spring, we get so many rainy days, and between the candle and this cozy throw and your tea, it just is such a cozy way to unwind. It's such a cozy way to unwind, and when you sit back, feel how plush this is. You're sold on it. Yeah, I have one on the back of my chair, and it is just so soft and so warm. Okay, I'm going to put this on your chair right now. Your desk looks so good, so inviting. It's got everything that you need, want, to ensure a wonderful writing session before bed. For me to light the candle so you can see the whole setup. Perfect. What do you think? I mentioned, I do this for my clients 4 times a year. So this spring setup will last you 3 months, and then I will be ready, and you will be ready for me to come back and give it a freshen, all new things. Yeah. So when you come home tomorrow, this will all be waiting for you. And I wish you a wonderful relaxing writing session that brings you peace.